Hello, 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 my lovelies. It is Talk Radio, TWK Radio, with your hostess Cypher Kai on the ones and twos tonight for this Worldwide Wednesdays. It is March 24th, 2021, and I'm broadcasting from the United States. Shout out to all of the international talkers. Shout out to all of the archivers. Shout out to everyone that's here, that's on the lines before I get on, and shout out to everyone who tunes in live and keeps this thing going back and forth in the archives and listening and spreading it around and all that wonderful stuff, yeah? So tonight is all about the headline news roundup. It is the Worldwide Wednesdays. I do have some new news pull for you guys tonight. I think I've got like five or six. New news are songs that are new to me, new to the platform. I'll be hearing them for the first time as I'm playing them. Hopefully new to you as well. And you can follow these artists by finding them in all the places they're available to purchase music and their social medias and things of that nature, yeah? So tonight we're going to have some interesting conversations. Tonight is not the sexually explicit content. The link went out and it said adult language can be used, because from time to time when I'm speaking about headline news, politics or something else, it rubs me the wrong way. An F-bomb has been known to fly out of my mouth. Not guaranteed, because it is an unscripted, uncensored show. And my audience and my sponsors trust me. So they allow me some latitude with certain things, yeah? Gonna play some music, though. Get sorted behind the scenes. And I do have some articles I want to dig into. Kind of what tonight's about. A couple of things happened that I'd like to discuss. Continuations of some things, confirmations of some things that I've said on the show before as well. This will give you guys homework to go back in the archives and check a few things. If you want to get into the public chat room and talk to me back and forth, on the website, www.tawkradio.com/shows. In the player, there's a talking bubble. Click it. From your desktop, it takes you somewhere, gives you some instructions. Now, also, if you want to text me live back and forth while I'm broadcasting, you've got two ways to do that. Dial 347-450-3958, 347-450-3958. You can text that number back and forth. If I can see it, I'll say it. And if you're an international talker or don't have long distance on your phone, go on to facebook.com/TAWKRADIO. Message me back and forth through the messenger portion of the Facebook page. All right. And Bob's your uncle. I think I got everything out. Right. So we're going to go play the songs in order in which I dropped them. Tonight's a mellow kind of evening. It'll be a light night, about an hour, hour and a half of the show. I'm going to play some music, a lot of R&B stuff, mostly from the ladies tonight. Just so happened to be the kind of vibe I'm in, just kind of wind down. A lot of violence happening. You know, people got their stimulus checks, just running out. Some people didn't get them. It's just kind of a musical tame the beast kind of energy today. This kind of vibe I'm on, yeah? Some slow down, enjoy mellow, mellow, get some wine or something. So the first one I'm going to play tonight is called I Like It, featuring Kiana Ledé and Seven Streeter and Coi Leray, here on the Worldwide Wednesdays Musical Mix at 6 on Talk Radio.
Oh, baby, so righteous, so righteous, so righteous. Oh, baby, I like it, yeah, I like it, I like it. Oh, you get me excited, excited, excited. Oh, baby, I like it, like it, like it. Cut these niggas off, cause you know you my type. Call up Aviani just to get my ice right. You right here, you not caught up in the nightlife.
TAWK Radio.
He gon' pull up on me, big B's on the wheel. He gon' vent to me, baby, tell me how you feel. Smile for me, baby, put the pussy on your grill. Don't lie to me, baby, promise that you'll keep it real. Gucci stepping when he walk in the room. Real nigga, yeah, I like how he move. He a boss and I like how he do it. Grab the camera, baby, let's make a movie. I need to know if it's worth it. Communication not working. Ay, come and show me that you bought it, babe. Ooh, you gotta earn it. Ooh, you're so righteous, so righteous, so righteous. Different kind of notes, singing higher than I do at my own shows. You got me singing your praises in my solo.
Yeah, TAWK Radio, Worldwide Wednesday.
I can't make out anything that you say. Yeah, only hearing my name. time. I need to know if it's working. Communication ain't perfect, so come and show me that you're about it, baby. Ooh, you gotta learn it. Said you'll be right back. Soon as you walk in, let you break my back. Why you licking on my lips? I might give you FaceTime. You're so close to the none of your cover, your face tag. Ooh, I'm tryna meet you outside the liquor store. I keep it tight and lit like the switch roll. So can you knock on my window? Bang, bang, make that shit crescendo. Ooh, make it now, make it urgent. I need communication in person. So
TAWK Radio with Cypher Kai. Worldwide Wednesdays with your hostess Cypher Kai on TAWK Radio. Ooh, so you guys are divinely connected to and currently tuned into www.tawkradio.com/shows. All right. Oh, tonight is all about the Worldwide Wednesdays. I think we're going to start a new segment tonight as well called Weird News Wednesday. Right. I came across this article that just kind of blew my mind just from the headline. I didn't read the article. I like to read the articles live on the air so we can all hear it for the first time together and then, you know, do a little commentary and a little shtick and whatever. But this one, the headline really caught my attention. So I think maybe right before I start talking about the headline news for the evening, I'll do the, you know, weird news segment in a few. I have to play a few more songs, right? So tonight is all about taking it easy. You know, we're going to pay some homage to the females tonight with the music. The new news, I don't remember if they're males, females. I think there was a mix, but tonight is more of a, you know, easygoing kind of evening on the Worldwide Wednesdays here. Tonight is all about the headline news roundup about some articles that I felt like I wanted to talk about. And as I've got the platform and you guys allow me, I will speak on some things here this evening. Some of them are confirmations, like I said, continuations of the things I mentioned here on the show before. And, you know, we're just going to have some really grown-up conversations tonight, yeah? If you guys missed the ABCs of Sex series, The Letter J, I believe we did, last week, Friday, that archive is available on the website as well. And last week in the Pistivity Corner Part 2, that was very informative, but quite profane. Profane, I should say, not vulgar, profane. So nothing sexually explicit in the Pistivity Corner episode, but it was very profane. I dropped a lot of, the F-bombs had wings last week Wednesday. They did, it just did. I was very, very upset about some things. Ergo, the title was Pistivity Corner. You know what I'm saying? All right, so the next song we're going to play here tonight is, the next three actually are going to be songs from Miss Maya. Shout out to Miss Maya, the R&B singer. You're amazing in everything you're doing. This new album she's got out, I really, really like it. But I pulled a few songs that had made the new news a couple of weeks ago, a couple of months ago, and I just was on the vibe to just play some things tonight. So for all the grown-ups who always say you feel left out, you're cuddled up with your boo, you're having what I like to call armpit time, it is raining in New York right now, you came in from work or you did your remote working, you turned your computer off, your phone off, and you just kind of hugged up with your boo right now, or with your teddy bear or whatever, and you're just want to relax and wind down. No need for the bangarang tonight, none of the, you know, just the extra tonight. Just taking it easy and enjoying talk radio. So tonight is all about that for you guys, yeah? Or you can use this as, you know, a nice playlist for some grown-up time on another day of the week. That's all I'm saying. So the next one we're going to play here tonight is called True Love by Maya here on the Worldwide Wednesdays musical mix at 6 on Talk Radio with your hostess Cypher Kai.
We're all looking for something more that we've been looking for.
TAWK Radio. WK Radio. Wednesdays with Cypher Kai. AWK Radio with your host Cypher Kai on the ones and two. Shout out to Anthony the Lyft driver early in the show, first 15 minutes or so. Good God, I meant to do it the first 5 minutes. I forgot. I'm sorry, my darling. Shout out to Anthony the Lyft driver. Shout out to Miss Sue, who is tuned in, one of our VIPs who's traveling. I know she's probably freaking out right now. I'm texting her back and forth, asking her all her business. Didn't mean to freak you out, Miss Lady. I'm just rather impressed that you're on vacation and took some time to listen to talk radio. That's all. No worries. No worries. I'm not stalking you. All right. So now, if you guys are just logging on, this is www.tawkradio.com/shows. And it is the Worldwide Wednesdays. And I'm your hostess, Cypher Kai. Tonight it's going to be all about the headline news roundup. Just some articles, not every single thing, but some articles that, you know, made headline news, international news, national news here in the United States that I just wanted to talk about. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of what it is. We're going to play some music. I pull some new news. I do have a new weird news segment I think I'm going to try out with you guys. Let me know if you like it. But something caught my attention today. The headline of it caught my attention. So I want to kind of read the article. I'm just going to talk about it, right? Why not? So tonight's the easygoing, mellow evening. The mellow evening with all the, you know, R&B and junk and neo-soul and things that's going to come up later on in the show. All right, then. So the next one from Miss Maya. It's like a Maya segment. I don't care. I'm unafraid. I'll say it. I'm a fan. I am. I'm a fan. Right. This next one is called Just Call My Name by Miss Maya here on the Worldwide Wednesday's Musical Mix at 6 on Talk Radio.
When the silence is so loud and you can't seem to find your way, all the worlds come crashing down. Just know you can count on me. You never thought the sky would fall on broken ground. Oh, yeah. When you're hurt inside, go ahead and cry, 'cause I know how you feel. Oh, you need somebody, 'cause nobody wants to fight all alone. Just know that you got me. I'll be there for you when you need it most.
WK Radio Worldwide Wednesdays.
All you gotta do is just call my name. Yeah, oh yeah. Oh. So many times I've been there before. Down and out, I could have let go, but I'm here right now for a reason.
So if you need somebody,
no one should have to fight all alone. Just know that you got me. I'll be there for you when you need it most. When you need it.
T A W K Radio.
Sunshine in your head. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
TAWK Radio with your hostess Cypher Kai on the ones and twos for this Worldwide Wednesdays here on www.tawkradio.com/shows. If you guys are international, you want to talk to me about anything I'm discussing this evening, and you know, you want to talk to me back and forth, that would be hit me up on the messenger on facebook.com/TAWKRADIO. If you are more local or you don't mind spending money for the long distance charges, you guys have a 24/7 hotline number I set up just for my talkers. That's 347-450-3958, 347-450-3958. You can leave voicemails there any time of the day or night to potentially be played live on the air. Also, you can text only live back and forth while I'm doing any broadcasts. Feel free to also go in and text live during a broadcast you might be re-listening to. That should be kind of dope for you, right? So I'm going to play one more Maya song here in this selection we got, and then I'm going to start discussing the topic of the evening, or the topics, the headlines of the evening that I've pulled that have riled my spirit in one way or another. And then we're going to play some of the new news and some other things and have a good time, just kind of relax together. All of the talkers, local, international, national, just kind of having like a nice slumber party of sorts. All right, so the next one here is called I Deserve It by Maya, here on the Worldwide Wednesdays musical mix at 6 on Talk Radio. WK Radio. UK Radio Worldwide Wednesdays. TalkRadio.com's Worldwide Wednesdays with your hostess Cypher Kai on the ones and twos. Now, as I'm talking to you guys, I told you guys before, this is a live, unscripted, and uncensored show. Yeah. So that means a lot of things. That means I'm human and flawed, and there might be some times you'll hear me stumbling on my tongue or things of that nature. Like I said, I read things live on the air. It's not because I can't read. I don't have glasses with me. There might be a couple of things going on. No excuses, but I'm just letting you know I'm fallible. Yeah. But as I'm talking to you guys here now, I'm looking at this delivery that I'm keeping track of for a talker that won some giveaways the other day. And it was supposed to be delivered today. And I'm checking this thing, and all of a sudden, this particular postal service, whose name I won't mention at the moment, is messing with me. And it seems as though it's not going to get there for a whole nother day. So I'm really kind of annoyed about this. I want them to get these giveaway gifts before Friday for our Freaky Fridays, because they won it from a Freaky Friday contest. I'm just saying. That's a side note. Anyway, tonight is all about the roundup of the headline news, right? And so some things came up that were piquing my interest and rubbing me wrong, right? And so I am, thank you so much. Oh my God, I got my VIPs listening right now. So shout out to Miss, what should I say about you? My Connecticut land developer. I've got big people that listen to my show. I've got a lady listening to my show right now. Her and her husband own multiple properties across the tri-state in New York City area, and she's taking out some time to listen to my little teeny tiny show with a couple hundred thousand of you tuned in as well. Oh my gosh. Thank you, Miss Ma'am. I don't want to say your name right now, but thank you. You know I'm talking about you. You just texted me in WhatsApp. You know I'm talking about you. I am. Shout out also to my landlord in SI, who's tuned in, I'm sure, with her husband, or will listen in the archives. I appreciate you guys immensely. Now, let me see if I can find this article, the first one. Now, I was telling you guys the other day, one of the things I had mentioned on the show was, you know, you guys assume because I tell you guys I'm black, you can't see me, but I'm a black woman, very proud to be. And, you know, you guys are always with the, black people always are supposed to be democratic. And if they're not democratic and they're Republican or got some other thoughts, they're a sellout, they're this and that. I'm an equal opportunity thinker. Yeah. And so it's not about Democrat or whatever. I tell you guys all the time, let me learn you a few things. Now, you sign up for certain parties for who you want to donate to have it on your driver's license, all these things. But here's the truth of it. You should always vote for the best shit shoveler. I said that. I said what I said, right? I told you guys there might be some F-bombs flying up my mouth tonight. Now, what that means, I remember we had an entire conversation on one of our Wednesday shows that you guys were completely up in arms when you heard 50 Cent, the rapper, the black rapper, was going to support Donald Trump. Oh my God, Lil Wayne was going to support Donald Trump. I'm not a Trump supporter. Before you guys start your nonsense, I'm leading to something. I'm going somewhere with this, right? But you're supposed to, and in the time, and I explained to you guys, you couldn't understand how it was I agreed with them, but was still not a Trump supporter. So let me help you. Let me learn you one more again, if you guys missed that archive. What you're supposed to do innately. So yes, Lil Wayne is a black rapper. 50 Cent is an entrepreneur. He's not even a rapper anymore, just alone. Entrepreneur, TV producer, a bottle water buyer, all kinds of things, yeah? So these guys are not the common average black people, right? Or any minority that's making little money anymore. They're making lots and lots of money. So if they had aligned themselves with Donald Trump, I don't think it's because they were ass-kissing this white guy. I think what the alignment was is that they know this sneaky bastard, Trump I'm talking about, had set things in a way and will always set things in a way to skew it in the better balance for him and his supporters, his contributors, that kind of thing. So when you reach into the levels of money that Lil Wayne and 50 Cent has, or Mr. Curtis Jackson has, you align yourself with people that will work in your specific best interest, which is what you're supposed to do. That is what you're supposed to do. Selfishly, whoever holds that office holds it for 4 years. Four. 1, 2, 3, 4 in the United States. Unless you pull a Putin, who found a way during the pandemic to finagle getting himself 16 years more in office, literally might be there till he dies, and then aligned himself with the churches, the Greek Orthodox Church or some nonsense. We talked about that as well as in the archive, right? So I say all that to say, I posed a question to you guys, I think last Wednesday, or the Wednesday before. And I said, who the hell is running the country at the moment. And not just because of all of the things that are happening all at the same time. It seems like they have no rhyme, no reason, no order, and no fixations at the moment. I make up words here, damn it. Right? So the question was, you know, Joe Biden's 78 years old. He is a career politician. Older guy, constantly making oral gaffes. And not say, to say gaffes. Look, he's an older person. Older people by design feel like, if I've lived to a certain age, I'm entitled to say certain things. I believe that. I subscribe to that myself. I do, right? I'm grown. I say what I say. I say what I said, right? So he's not really been accomplishing a lot, but there's a lot to do. Those of you who voted for him thinking he's going to come in and take a big ass broom and clean up all the mess that Donald Trump made, not really possible to do that from anyone coming in the first couple days, even in 4 years. It takes a long time to clean up a big ass political mess. Now, has he made some things bigger? Yes, I think so. So when I posed the question to you guys and I said, who's running the country? Right? Who's really running it? They didn't have him speaking much during the leading up to the election. They didn't want to say anything crazy for the sound bites to be flying around, all that. So at some point this week, I believe he fell up the stairs, going to Air Force One. Going on Air Force One, fell up the stairs 3 times. Now, you know, it's kind of hard to fall upwards 3 times. Could his legs have been weak? Could be. A plane is really high off the ground, lots of stairs. Lots of different things. Now, I kept saying when I was talking about this during the elections and leading up to it, you know, he's got this woman, yeah? And I understand the importance of having coochie that close to the button, coochie that close to the power. And I'm saying that specifically for a reason, not to diminish her as a person, but we have this whole narrative of, oh, you know, first black woman in office and this and this and this. Let's discuss that. So she's Jamaican and Indian. I tell you, it would have given me no more pleasure than for her to say at one point, just something, some Jamaican patois, something very deep to let people know not to mess with us. You know what I'm saying? Not to fuck with us. Right? It would have probably been order, but she didn't do it, right? But besides that, the question then becomes, all right, so he's falling down, they're not letting him speak. How many times have you guys ever heard her refer to herself as a black woman before she started running? She's Jamaican and Indian, like from India. She's married to a Caucasian guy. And the only time I heard them even talking about her being a black woman, is when they were running. Maybe I'm mistaken. I don't know, right? I think she's black for convenience. Not knocking her. You got to embrace both sides. But scientifically speaking, though, from what I recall from way, way back in the back of my brain somewhere, biologically speaking, you are the race of your dad. That's how that works, right? The race of your father. The nutsack is what creates the race of you. Mommy carries you. And again, one of those most beautiful things about black women, only us specifically, because we are just divinely designed that way, a black woman can carry a pure race of any other race. Let me learn you. So if a black woman gets with an Asian man, the child can be mixed looking, or they can have dark complected skin, slanted eyes and all the other features, or the baby can come out looking exactly completely Asian. The nice hair, the light skin, the whole nines. We are the only ones with this magical front that can do this, right? So her dad is Jamaican, so she would be Jamaican by divine design anyway. Just saying. But none of that seems to be, you know, appreciated at all until she was running. Not for nothing. And I've not done any research on the husband yet either. Need to go dig around and see. Don't do all the scandal. Not really looking for scandal. Just kind of want to know what he does besides bang the second in command to the United States. Just kind of want to know, right? What else does he do? What else is his claim to fame besides banging the second person next to the power? The second person next to the button. What does he do? Kind of want to know what he does. I'll do some research on that soon enough. But I say all that to say, after Biden fell up the stairs and these memes were flying around about him being frail and this and that, there was another snippet, you know, Trump poked his head up out of his whatever hole he's in. I told you guys, the lamestream media doesn't want to acknowledge that she could be in power really quickly. Now, that's important. That is important. And we're going to discuss that some more from both sides of the aisle, right? Something that Mr. Biden, President Biden, did, and then a conversation that Trump has had before, has been having again. I wanted to give you guys that background before I gave you that. We're going to jump into the new news first. New news are songs that are new to me, new to the platform, hopefully new to you as well. We're going to hear them all for the first time together here on the show. This first new is called No Plans for Love. D-Nice featuring Neo and Kent Jones here on the Worldwide Wednesdays Musical Mix at 6 on Talk Radio.
Welcome to CQ. D-Nice, Neo, Kent Jones. Here we go. High vibrations. Celebrating love and life. Come on.
There's a dark shine in her eyes. I heard story after story, no surprise.
Here we go.
Till one day, face to face. For love, not the case. Said I know better than to fall into the category of your beck and call. Hey, try to warn me that first night. She said that I'd be coming back and she was right.
TAWK Radio. WK Radio Worldwide Wednesdays. WK Radio. That was a good one. Oh my goodness, you guys. That sounds really, really good. All right, so that was a new. That's the first time I've played this song on the show. And what happens is when I put songs into the new section, you guys listen to it, give me your feedback, you follow the artist, all that stuff. But then also it has the opportunity to play, you know, going forward on other Wednesdays or other days of the show that we use. And it's really, really good. All right. So, let's continue. This is the Worldwide Wednesdays Musical Mix at 6 on Talk Radio. And tonight is all about the headline news roundup. So we were talking about President Joe Biden in the United States and his running, I can't say running mate anymore, my God, the vice president, the first female vice president of the United States, Kamala Harris. Now, I don't want you guys to figure I'm being disrespectful or I'm negating what's been going on and how much this means for women and all that. I'm not saying that, not at all. This is a whole different conversation. We've already done that, right? We've done the accolades. We've done all of that. I'll even talk about at one point, I think another day, how pissed off Hillary Clinton must be. My God, poor baby. My Lord. But what I want to talk about now is the gaffes, right? So President Biden fell up the stairs. Live radio. Let me be respectful. Now, there's a lot of times when I spoke about the president of the United States when Trump was in office, and I kept calling him Mr. Trump. And not because I'm disrespectful, because he was not acting like a president, right? Mr. President Biden has not given me any reason to treat him that way yet. So President Biden, let me be respectful. President Biden fell up the stairs of Air Force One 3 times last week, made memes, went viral, all that other stuff. Yeah. So at one point, I came across this article that had a headline. I didn't read it, but it was saying President Biden called VP Harris President Harris as he was talking about the vaccine rollout. Now, here's the thing. During a press conference touting COVID-19 vaccine rollout on Thursday, President Biden, 78 years old, experienced a slip of the tongue about his second in command. The hardest hit and suffered the most, especially Black, Latino. Okay, let's get to that point. He himself, the president himself, made a mistake, or was it? That he called Kamala Harris the president. You, the president, spoke about your VP when you introduced her as the president of the United States. Now, let's take a second with that. Now, we can call it a gaffe. It can be called, people think he's got onset dementia, all kinds of things, but not for nothing. How many of you, when you voted for this ticket, besides the fact of wanting to oust President Trump, right? Ex-President Trump, were you thinking to yourself, you know what? First of all, they can't be worse than Trump. And not for nothing, as a little stick you in the ass to everybody else who tried before, right? So Miss Clinton has been trying to run for quite some time. And I think her demise was trying to separate herself and distance herself from her husband, right? Because not for nothing, those of us who are grown, let's take a second, sidebar. Those of us who are grown, yeah? Those people who are over 40, who can remember when Clinton was in office, besides all the other things of the humanitarian stuff and the things he did out of the country. Let's think about it for a second. When Bill Clinton was in office, and if you're old enough, you've got to be old enough, right? If you, especially for Black people, let's talk like we're honest. Let's have honest conversations here. First of all, let me speak for myself. I recall living in New York City when President Clinton was in office, and I got to witness with my own eyes and pride swelling in my chest, Black people who wanted to being able to achieve so many things. I saw dollar van drivers, man, I saw dollar van drivers, West Indian guys who put together their own transportation network alongside of the MTA in New York City to transport Black people from the communities where taxi cab drivers were not taking us up from, where the buses were running slow, put together these networks and purchase homes and property with dollar van money, yo. Ah, I got to witness Black people, aunties and grandmas go under their pillows and under their boobs and their bras, take out their money, pay their susu and buy property, man, under this guy. I saw this under Clinton. And not for nothing, I've been a bit of a political whore for quite some time. Not ashamed to say that. I thought in my lifetime, I thought the closest I'd get to a Black president was Bill Clinton. Oops, I said that. I said what I said. I'll say it again. Let's think about Mr. Clinton. So, Mr. Clinton, Mr. Ex-President Bill Clinton, he, down south, eats comfort food. I'm going to say a lot of salacious things, but we're just having conversations here, shits and giggles, yeah? Eating southern comfort food, right? He played the saxophone. The man smoked weed. Didn't lie about it. Got a blowjob in the White House from an intern. What? Kennedy had an entire mistress that had her own Secret Service detail. What's the big whoop? He got his dick sucked in there. He's not the only one. Whatever, right? And then, not for nothing, am I the only one who's ever noticed how coarse Bill Clinton's hair seems to be? Kind of like that, you know, Justin Timberlake course, like that Prince Harry course, like somewhere in your line, the lines have gotten muddied and someone didn't really tell you who your daddy really is kind of course. I'm starting some arguments right now. So what? And so what? And Bob's your uncle. So what? So what? So in my lifetime, I thought the closest we would ever get, because of the way things are set up in this country, because of the fact that years and years after slavery had finished, legally, my air quotes are up, there was still, you know, another level of the civil rights movement and all the racism we experience now up until this day, today, March 24th, 2021. Yeah? So I thought the closest we would ever get would have been Bill Clinton. And then we got Mr. Barack Obama, my God. Besides him being articulate and handsome, not for nothing, not for nothing. Let's take a moment with that. He had a black wife with, not a mixed black wife, nothing wrong with the mixed sisters, but a black wife who had permed hair and educated, moved her, their black children into the White House with her black mum into the White House and their black dog. Just the whole blackness in the White House that was built by black slaves. Not for nothing. Just learn you a thing or three. Learn you a thing or three here on talk radio, yeah? So I thought that was so prevalent. So the president of the United States currently is calling his second in command the president. Maybe it's a premonition. Hmm? Who's really running the country? What are they up to? But of course, if they publicize that too much, this place would be up in arms. You can't have, listen, not for nothing. The narrative would be, okay, so we got rid of one nigger. And there's a hierarchy to this. And I said nigger. Mean nothing by it. Don't start with me. Oh, it's going to go into a, listen here. We have a conversation. I said what the narrative is going to be. Not what my thoughts are, but the narrative is going to be. So we had one black guy got in after 200 and something years of our fake-ass democracy here in the United States. Got one black guy in. He got two terms. As far as they're concerned, the next in command should have been another white guy, which they did. The white guy should have gotten two terms. And then, if anything, the hierarchy would have been Latino man, Republican, of course, maybe Caucasian woman, right? And then maybe a black woman as the second to somebody else. That's the hierarchy here. That's how that goes. Mm-hmm. So the fact that we got one term of a white guy in after Barack's two terms, and then we got somebody who's on Barack's ticket back in with an educated black woman next to him. Ooh, Lord. Not for nothing. Not for nothing. Not a conspiracy theory, but I'm kind of feeling like the reason why all this violence is breaking out all over the place, there's something brewing, you guys, because they feel like the sister, the yardie, is about to get too close to that button, you know? And I'd like to believe, you know, that the Democrats have been rolling over on a lot of stuff. And I do lay a lot of the things that Donald Trump got away with at their feet. I said that. I say what I say. I said what I said. And I said that before on the show. Because I feel like they empowered him and enabled him to do a lot of the bullshit he did. Right? Oh, our hands are tight. Bullshit. There's a lot more things that could have been done, but we'll talk about that on another show another day as well. But I say all that to say he made that gaffe, and it goes back to what Donald Trump was saying, that, hey, you know, I was telling you guys, this old guy here, you know, what's going on with him? I think he's got dementia. I think he's got this, I got that. And now this woman is going to be in charge. And I think that's what a lot of that he used to rile up his base as well, because not for nothing, let's not forget, he got 70-something million people to vote for him. This wasn't like a landslide type thing. He had 70-something million people who are not happy with the status quo, who are not happy with what's going on and who's sitting there. And they're showing this. We'll get to that as well. The next new for the evening tonight on this Worldwide Wednesday's Musical Mixer 6 on Talk Radio with your hostess Cypher Kai on this slow down version of the show is called, what's this one? Freaky As Me. Jacquees featuring Mulatto here on the Worldwide Wednesday's Musical Mixer 6 on Talk Radio.
Oh, oh, oh.
Quee!
Yeah, Mulatto. Tell me, are you freaky as me?
Freaky as me.
Girl, I wanna know how far we could go. Tell me if you freaky as me.
Freaky as me.
Girl, I wanna know, I wanna know. Are you freaky as me? When I spank on that booty, don't run.
Don't run.
No talking, see the cat got my tongue.
My tongue.
Licking on your legs, licking on your toes. Anything goes, just let me know.
See, your body's all I need.
Here next to me.
Whoa.
UK Radio.
Choke on it till my nose run. Fuck me on the bed full of old honey. We get straight to it cause we both want it. Make my ankles touch the headboard. Know this pussy here is still bad for it. Kitchen counter to the shower for an hour. What the fuck we need a bed for? This the type of pussy that a nigga send a jet for. Put a yellow sign up when I'm done.
Tell me, are you freaky? It's me. Girl, I wanna know how far we could go. Tell me if you freaky, it's me.
AWK Radio's Worldwide Wednesdays with your hostess Cypher Kai on the ones and twos tonight. www.tawkradio.com/show. Shout out to Mr. Ware in the public chat room. Hello, hello. Thank you for coming over to hang out. If you guys have missed any of the archives of Talk Radio, understand a few things. One, this is an adult platform, so whether I'm dropping F-bombs and talking about political things on a Wednesday, it can be very grown. Also, on Fridays, the only 2 days we broadcast right now are Wednesdays and Fridays. Fridays is extremely sexually explicit and profane. So it is definitely not for the faint of heart, not for children underage. I need you guys to be parents. Do not sit here blaming me when your children stumble across the website. Like, oh, I can't believe you say that stuff. I can't believe you're not monitoring your child. And there, Bob's your uncle. All of the links that go up for the show, I know for a fact because I've been doing it myself. Right, all the links that go out for the show, especially for the past couple months, have said explicit adult content, headphones required, not suggested, not to think about it, required, unless you're grown and you play me on your Bluetooth speakers or in the speakers in your car, whatever, but it is required. Do some parenting, guys. Do a little parenting. All right. So as this is the Worldwide Wednesday, we do have some articles from around the globe. Shout out to the Indian community that listens to the show, right? Ooh. Hello, Mr. Marcus from Jersey. Nice to have ya. Oh, my God. Now, Mr. Marcus is an essential worker. Yes, he is a nurse. Yes, they have male nurses before you guys start your nonsense. And so he was an essential worker before it was deemed essential work. So shout out to Mr. Marcus, tuned in from New Jersey. Now, the funny thing is, I know there was a very popular stripper back in the days in the 90s called Mr. Marcus. Are you the same person? Interesting. Anyway, so India claims it has spotted a new double mutant COVID variant. Oh, Lord. Hi. Okay. A new double mutant COVID-19 has been detected in samples in India, health officials have claimed. Experts in the western states, experts in the western state of, something with an M, I can't pronounce it. I won't butcher it. There's a country in India with the M name that starts with, can't pronounce it, are now working to understand whether or not it could be more infectious and resistant to vaccines. Now, here's the funny thing. I'm going to talk about this very briefly. I've talked about the vaccine so much on the show. For those of you who feel the need to take it, not ducking you, not downing you, if you've taken them, I hope you don't have any negative side effects and all that. Personally, I don't feel like I should get the vaccine yet. I am not volunteering to do it, not when it's my turn, as well as it's been my turn, but whatever, not interested in doing it. But responsibly and respectfully, I've also been keeping away from people. So it's not as though I'm flouting in my face and saying, oh, well, I'm not doing it, but I'm around people coughing and, you know, my face is open and just all kinds of things. I'm not doing that, right? So, but they've said to people already from the very beginning, Well, this is not going to really stop you from giving COVID to other people, and it won't help you against the other mutant strains and variants and this and this and this. And you're going to have to take it every year now for the rest of your life and all that other stuff. And, you know, and I just, it just doesn't ring true to my spirit. It's not something I want to volunteer and do now. I also never took the flu shot to go, well, it's just like the flu shot. I never took the flu shot either. Why? Because I had a West Indian mum. And so what we do, we eat properly. As best we can. I eat like shit sometimes, but I'm saying when you have, you keep home remedy stuff in your house, right? Now, for most of the West Indians, any Africans, Spanish people, you know, we know what to do. In any area we have access to a Chinese fruit stand, we go get stuff, don't we? We keep coconut oil in the house. We got Vicks in the house. We got Alcalado in the house. We got bay rum in the house. We have limes in the house, ginger in the house. We have, what else we keep in there? Well, ginger really fixes everything, doesn't it? But we keep things in the house preemptive to something happening. Yeah. So I never took the flu shot either. And neither did my children. I think the first time they got that one, I think, is when they went off to college. It was mandated. Literally, they had to have it before they got on campus. And I didn't want them wasting their scholarship money. But I don't subscribe to vaccines and things. And again, nothing wrong with those who do. But I believe in keeping yourself healthy and being proactive instead of reactive. Right. So that's just my own personal thing. Right. So I'm just saying that. So now they're going to have all these mutant variant this and mutant variant that. Everything's opening up. And I'm saying all of this to say one more again, right? One more again. I know what I'm saying. I say what I say. I said what I said, right? One more again. Please, you guys, prepare for the next lockdown. Lots of other countries are already having their second wave, third wave. Some places in Europe are closing down again. Italy, this way. It is coming. Whether it's for a political reason, whether it's a voluntary or an involuntary lockdown, let me explain. Now, involuntary lockdown means they say, oh, the COVID numbers went up because all of a sudden King Cuomo realizes he might be losing this battle he's fighting in, so he's got to control things again and lock everything the hell back down. In New York, potentially, probably. I'm just saying. Remember, I said it today. Or involuntary lockdown, you guys realize that it is, people are getting very wild outside. They're still flustered. Remember, the eviction moratoriums are just coming up soon in New York. It's going to be a bloodbath out here. Literally and proverbially, I believe. People are going to be overly frustrated. You know, I think the CDC was even flouting potentially extending it again. These small landlords are getting squashed and crushed. People who are out here expecting to sit down on their asses and collect back rent money and all these things. Again, I'm going to learn you guys some things. There's an article I pulled. I will read it, snippets of it, where I told you guys in preparation of this day coming, because the dollars had to mash up at some point, this day coming, anybody who is getting enhanced unemployment, which is very easily verifiable by your same social security number that you put on your lease, that is running with the government, getting your extra money, was not entitled, at least in New York, to get rental assistance. And before you guys are like, well, I had other bills and this and that, you also got to secure your roof. Other things can come. Here's the thing. You can carpool to work. You can get grocery from food pantries. Lower your egos. You could have sent your children to go to school all during the pandemic. Even when the children were not in school, I told you guys that the schools were open. They were giving bag lunches. You could have gone to pick up and heat up in your house. There are ways to get, you know what I'm going to do one of these days? I'm going to do a couple Wednesdays from now. I'm going to sit down and teach you guys some of the things that I did to get by. I had things very tight, very hard, and I had three little babies to tend to. And there's just ways that you can get around taking care of everything. I'm a survivor. I am. Not a survivalist. I'm not outside rubbing sticks together, making fires and things. But there's ways that you can humble yourself and make a little bit do a lot. And you guys need to start learning that. I thought a lot of people would have taken the time to start learning these things over the course of the pandemic. But clearly you didn't do it, right? So there's not a lot of tears and tissues for you crying now that, oh my God, I was making $1,000 a week during the pandemic and now I've got no money to pay my rent. There's not going to be a lot of tissue for you. The violins are going to stop playing, the whole nine yards, because I told you guys this was coming. And for those of you who are actually in need and are hurting, the ones of you who could not get the enhanced unemployment because maybe you were a gig worker or you worked in a restaurant. So I'm not talking about you guys. I'm not talking about you guys. And I'm going to do some special cash up giveaways for you guys coming up soon in the coming months. Right? I'm talking about you fucking gluttons. You gluttons who thought you were getting over on the system. The ones of you who are burning landlords and sitting in their houses, inviting people in, having illegal house parties and all kinds of other nonsense, not doing anything to make money from said house or making money from the house and not paying your rent. Your reckoning is coming. And some of you who I know personally, oh my God. I'm going to have an invisible erection when I see the marshals come drag your asses out of these places. Oh, I said what I said. I said what I said. Anyway, Worldwide Wednesdays here on talkradio.com with your hostess, Cypher Kai. All right, so the next one here I'm going to play on the new news section is Peaches, Justin Bieber featuring Daniel Caesar and Givian. Okay, this should be interesting. On the Worldwide Wednesdays on Talk Radio.
I got my peaches out in Georgia.
Oh yeah, shit.
I get my weed from California.
That's that shit.
I took my chick up to the north, yeah.
Badass bitch.
I get my light right from the source, yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
And I see you. Oh. The way I breathe you in. Hey. It's the texture of your skin. I wanna wrap my arms around you, baby, never let you go. Oh. And I see you. There's nothing like your touch. It's the way you lift me up. Yeah, and I'll be right here with you till the end.
I got my peaches out in Georgia.
Oh yeah, shit.
I get my weed from California.
That's that shit.
I took my chick up to the north, yeah.
Badass bitch.
I get my light right from the source, yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
You ain't sure yet, but I'm for ya. All I could want, all I could wish for. Nights alone that we miss more, and days we save as souvenirs. There's no time, I wanna make more time and give you my whole life.
TAWK Radio.
Hate to leave a college torture. Remember when I couldn't hold her? Left her baggage for a mover.
I got my peaches out in Georgia.
Yeah, shit.
I get my weed from California.
That's that shit.
I took my chick up to the north, yeah.
Badass bitch.
I get my light right from the source, yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
I get the feeling, so I'm sure. And in my hand because I'm yours. I can't pretend I can't ignore you right from me. Don't think you wanna know just where I've been. Oh, don't be distracted. The one I need is right in my arms. Your kisses taste the sweetest with mine. And I'll be right.
I got my peaches out in Georgia.
Oh yeah, shit.
I get my weed from California.
That's that shit.
I took my chick up to the north, yeah.
Badass bitch.
I get my light right from the source, yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
I got my peaches out in Georgia.
Oh yeah, shit.
I get my weed from California.
That's that shit.
I took my chick up to the north, yeah.
Badass bitch.
I get my light right from the source, yeah.
I got my peaches out in Georgia.
Oh yeah, shit.
I get my weed from California.
That's that shit.
I took my chick up to the north, yeah.
Badass bitch.
I get my light right from the source, yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
I got my peaches out in Georgia.
Oh yeah, shit.
I get my weed from California.
That's that shit.
I took my chick up to the north, yeah.
Badass bitch.
I get my light right from the source, yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
Wow, I think I'm doing pretty decent tonight. That song was pretty cool too. Love the new news, you guys. New news, new to me, new to the platform, hopefully new to you too. That was Mr. Justin Bieber, Daniel Caesar, and Givian. Okay, that was interesting. I think I've got three more new news for you guys. All right, so let's continue in this, I guess, the vaccine vein, right? So it was brought to my attention that... The virus hits Lago. COVID outbreak at Trump's Mar-a-Lago, forcing partial closures of the former president's Palm Beach resort. Now, That's according to several people familiar with the situation, including a club member who received a phone call about the closure on Friday. Now, you know, isn't it funny that I believe that Donald Trump called it the China virus? He doesn't believe in it. He had his supporters believing he's got God genes because he was able to go into the hospital, not having it, right? Not saying it doesn't exist. I don't think he specifically had it, right? He goes in at 70-something years old, eating like garbage, running around all the time, always on fucking Twitter, not fucking sleeping, you know, compromised immune system, I'm sure, but goes in, gets some kind of cocktail of some things, and then all of a sudden he gets to come outside running around with his literally assed out in his hospital gown, waving to people. Go back to the White House after taking said cocktail, no mask on his face, not pressing anything, even after having a super spreader event at the White House. So how did he get this non-existent virus to shut down his business? Interesting. But you didn't hear that from me, or did you? Did you hear it from me? Of course you did. He's full of shit. Right. Yes, the virus exists. I'm not saying it doesn't. I'm just personally saying I'm not willing to use myself as a human petri dish to take these people's vaccines, either one of them. Not the Moderna, not the Pfizer, not the Johnson & Johnson one shot, not the AstraZeneca, none of that shit. None of it. Oh, well, you won't be able to fly anywhere, and you won't be able to do anything, and so what? I wasn't doing it anyway. I've not been on a plane since, I think, 1992 or some shit. Whatever. Anywho, let's continue. This is the Worldwide Wednesdays Musical Mix at 6 on Talk Radio with your hostess, Cypher Kai. And I want to talk about something very interesting when we come back. Reparations. We're going to talk about reparations. Black people get excited. Maybe. Kind of. I didn't read the entire article. I saw the... I saw the subject line, it caught my attention, and I said, you know what, I think I'm going to talk about this tonight. I'm going to play another Nunu and come back and talk about reparations here in the United States. Let's have some fun with that tonight. The next Nunu is called 1230 by Jai, or Jay, J-A-I. I'm not sure how you pronounce that. We're going to say Jai, like Kai Jai, here on the Worldwide Wednesdays Musical Mix at 6 on Talk Radio.
It was about 12:30. She was fucking it up. She was fucking it up. She was fucking it up for me, shawty. I can't get enough. I can't get enough. But I'ma give you what you need. She was fucking it up. She was fucking it up. She was fucking it up for me. I can't get enough. I can't get enough. She just called her boys, thought she was shy, so she got off them drugs. Now we high, say she wanna drive. Shawty cut sass, I'ma treat it like it's
mine. Rush like TAWK Radio. Then
we're by 9, switching up your home by 5. The little bitch the main line, better 100 that the pussy don't dry. Drink when I drive, motherfucker DUI. Hit the pussy from the side, had a nigga checking on time. It was about 12:30. She was fucking it up. She was fucking it up. She was fucking it up for me, shawty. I can't get enough. I can't get enough. But I'ma give you what you need. She was fucking it up. She was fucking it up.
TAWK Radio Worldwide Wednesday.
I can't get enough. I got dead bodies in my safe. My son and Adolf ain't coming. The out in May. I threw some racks to my baby mama. Tell her go safe. I don't even fuck with Swiss or Swiss. The backwards ain't my thing. I heard that they don't like my product. That's okay. I walk in the mall, drown everybody. Tripping on everything. I told her anything she wanna get. I'ma pay. I told my plug I need a product. Keep coming like underlay. She keep coming like can't ride this way with no skates. Can't pin that case with no face. Sanitize my hands in the bank. Book a flight now I'm on my way. She come to accommodate. I would climb for a lean out of state. Rolex, what's the time of day? It was about 12:30. She was fucking it up. She was fucking it up. She was fucking it up for me, shawty.
I can't get enough. I can't get enough. But I'ma give you what you need. She was fucking it up. She was fucking it up. She was fucking it up for me. I can't get enough. I can't get enough.
AWK Radio with your host, Cypher Kai. You guys are amazing. Oh my God, you're so in tuned with what's going on. And so many of you are saying, well, I don't make enough money, and how can we do this? I promise I'm going to do an entire show, right? We're going to call it the granny budget, right? Because I know a lot of you, those of you who grew up around elders, right? Maybe down south, west, or whatever, they knew how to put rubber bands on money. That's what I call it. See, there's a rubber band term, right? So you've got like a lot of money and it's so big you can't fit in your wallet. You put a rubber band around it. Kind of the same, kind of the reverse of it. Like you can make money stretch out. I remember when I had the kids and they were little, and they're big kids. And so, yeah, the cost of living has gone up and whatever. But you can buy things and make things and do things to make up the difference of what you got going on, right? I mean, when I tell you my finances were like non-existent, and I'm going to give you guys testimony about my kids and the things I was able to do and what I was able to do it with and the resources we use. We're going to talk about all that stuff, tell you all my business. Not today, though. We're going to do it on another show. I'm going to take some time, find some more resources, because you guys were like, well, that was a long time ago because your kids are big. What about now? So I'm going to find some now resources as well and make that stuff available to you, because you can. You just have to want to. Everything doesn't have to be what you guys are doing now. You don't have to be ordering from, you know, the food sites and all these things all the time. You don't have to. And yes, I know that groceries are getting expensive, but like I said, there's ways to put things together, mix and match things together, and make it work out. We're going to talk about all that stuff. I promise we will talk about that stuff on Talk Radio. So this is Talk Radio with your host, Cypher Kai. You guys, I'm sorry. I'm not getting a chance to see or respond to the messages and things you guys are sending me. I'm so hyper right now where I'm sitting. I suffer from hot flashes because I'm an old lady. I am. I know. And where I am now, it's not properly ventilated, and I'm just hot. I'm just really hot. So as opposed to getting flustered, reading things back and forth, if something pops right into my face, I can read it. But other than that, I'm not really getting to it. I'm actually going to play another song, and then we're going to come back and talk about reparations here on the show tonight. Another new that I pulled. You guys got a lot of new news tonight. This next one is called Glory of History. This is the ZYG808 featuring JJ Nice and Chris Koch. Here on the Worldwide Wednesdays Musical Mix at 6 on Talk Radio.
Okay, class. Today, you're all going to present the quotes that you found from famous American historical figures. Zig, you go first.
Okay. My quote is, I believe one man is just as good as another as long as he's honest and decent and not a nigger or a Chinaman. Former United States President Harry S. Truman.
Go to the office.
ZYG808.
You know they don't like it when you tell them the truth.
Even if it's something that they need to hear badly. Like, come on, bro.
Nigger! Chinaman!
That came from your president. What, you don't believe me? Well, how about I say that quote again? If you're a nigger or Chinaman, he don't think you're good enough. Nothing's really changed. That quote sounds like it came from Donald Trump. Ha, I'm laughing cause he's out of office, but I don't have much trust for that man he took that loss to. I wanted Bernie Sanders, but I got Sleepy Joe. He's the one that's spreading stereotypes on video. Oh no, now the left is mad at me. They're coming at my neck like, hey yo, what's your problem, ZYG? I thought you hated Trump. What's up with that family fire? My only choices were two racists who should've retired.
Nigger, Chinaman,
that came from your president. What, you don't believe me? Well, how about I say that quote again? If you're a nigger or Chinaman, he don't think you're good enough. Nothing's really changed. That quote sounds like it came from Donald Trump.
TAWK Radio.
Last time I checked,
They was from the Europeans. So nigga, I don't care what they really gotta say. I'm counting blue $100 to my fucking face. The white man always got a problem, got something to say. They always talking down on another race. So what you mean, nigga, this is not even a place. I'm going nuts, I'm going crazy, so I don't care what they say.
That came from your president. What, you don't believe me? Well, how about I say that quote again? If you're a nigger or Chinaman, he don't think you're good enough. Nothing's really changed. That quote sounds like it came from Donald Trump.
These niggas is racist, club full of hollows and sit on the pavement. Niggas in the hood be angry, try flip coke and a nigga got baby. Seeing my life in HD, whipping three baby, try to see an AP. Young niggas still going crazy, word to Drew, my nigga shit brazy. Niggas try to see different revenues, fuck Donald Trump and Devin News. And fuck Pelosi, nigga I'm different, nigga she don't know me. OG still going low key, blowing on loud and nigga got hosey. Shooting like nigga was Kobe, nigga just know me, government phony.
That came from your president. What, you don't believe me? Well, how about I say that quote again? If you're a nigger or Chinaman, he don't think you're good enough. Nothing's really changed. That quote sounds like it came from Donald Trump.
Oh my goodness, TAWK Radio with your hostess Cypher Kai. What? This is why I like to listen to things live on the air with you guys as well. I did not know what to expect when I saw the title of that song. I said, what? Glory of History. That was really good and kind of in line with some of the things I've been saying. Look how God works everything out. And yes, I talk about God. Yes, I believe in God. Not because you hear me here going on in the show. Yes, I do. And don't judge me. And Bob's your uncle, whatever. But yeah, that was really good. And I did not know Harry Truman said that. I feel like I need to go and dig up and look for that speech now and hear what other ignorant things he said during the course of that speech. What? I love it. You guys learn things on talk radio, I keep telling you. And look how convenient that song came on, the subject matter they were talking about. And right now, I'm about to have a conversation about reparations. Uh-huh. So let's talk about it, yeah, on talk radio. Let's see. They said, payback time. Evanston, Illinois votes to approve first system of $25,000 slavery reparations for black residents. What? Let's see what they're talking about here. The city of Evanston, Illinois voted to approve the first system of $25,000 slavery reparations for black residents in the United States. The city will now begin paying out $25,000 payments to black community members as part of a $400,000 payment the council voted on Monday night. Now how are they going to disperse this? Let's see. All right. In an 8-1 vote, members of the Evanston City Council approved the funds to be doled out. The payments will be given to 16 community members to be put toward housing. Reparation payments to be paid out are part of a $10 million plan backed by the City Council that are to be paid out over the next decade. Oh, Lord. All right, let's just keep going. Evanston is the first city, is the first U.S. city to offer reparation money to black residents whose families suffered damage from discriminatory practices, including racist housing policies. The $10 million fund was raised from a 3% tax on the sale of recreational marijuana as it tries to address inequity in housing. Evanston's reparations program received mixed reactions, with 9th Ward Alderman Cicely Fleming noting that residents don't have a say on how funds are doled out. She noted that money may go directly to mortgage lenders. As a housing program, I think it's great, she said. As a reparations program, it falls very flat to me. Thank you, Alderman. What's her name now? Alderman, shit, where'd it go? Alderman Cicely Fleming. Hello. Thank you. Now, I got all excited. That's what I tell you. I like to read things live on the air so we get it unscripted and uncensored. And, ooh. Now, if you thought this was going to be easy, the F-bombs are about to start flying now, isn't it? All right. So let's do some talk radio math. First, I got excited. I said $25,000 a person. It falls short of what it should be, but damn, that will help a lot of people. Nothing like that. 16, so effectively, 16 community-based organizations going to get $25,000 a piece to help people, you know, with like voucher. I guess you guys relate to in New York, like voucher type payments to help pay off rent. Now, here's the funny thing, yeah. In the United States, at the end of slavery, they had promised black people, ex-slaves, 40 acres and a mule. I'm going to dig into this a little further at another time, but tonight I just want to touch on it a little bit. I always thought that was disrespectful as fuck. Let's get the F-bombs flying from now. Let's put some wings on the F-bombs from now. 40 acres and a mule, right? So, 40 acres is really big. You think, oh my God, we could have planted our own tobacco. All the things we already knew how to do to make the white people money we could have done for ourselves. But your family at that point was so beaten down, so worn down, so, you know, just coming off of that. So to do it for yourself, you could have probably found the energy, the mental fortitude to do it. But you didn't have the equipment, right? You didn't give you, they gave you 40 acres, allegedly. They were promising you 40 acres and a mule. But mules don't breed. So from the time you work that mule to death on this land and it dies, that's it. You know, it's like a mule is like a bastard horse, isn't it? It doesn't procreate. Yeah? So then you're forced to go out there and till all this land by yourself, with the odds of maybe no one buying it, people going out and burning your shit, whatever. But they never gave it anyway. No 40 acres and a mule. The closest we got to 40 acres and a mule was the name of Spike Lee's production company with all the black films that he put out. We didn't get our 40 acres and a mule. But I don't know if you guys know this, but I believe it was in the early 2000s. In the 1990-somethings or early 2000s in this country, I know that there was money given to Holocaust survivors here in the United States. And I want to do some more research on this to talk about it properly. I remember coming across an article before because, as I told you guys, I've been a political whore for quite some time. Right, loving to know what's going on, headline news and politics and all that. And so the Holocaust happened on a whole other continent. Whole other continent. Yet they were able to receive payouts over here. And the United States had a gigantic hand in what was going on with that situation. And we're going to dig into that as well. And I know that's going to start some arguments, and I welcome them. Because someone had the gall one time to challenge me and tell me to get over slavery that took hundreds and hundreds of years of my people being stolen, displaced, brought to another place where that other situation happened over there in another country, and it was spoken of, addressed, and welcomed. Woo, you're not ready for me with this conversation. You guys are not ready for me with this conversation. I want to make sure, if I can, when I have that conversation, I want live phone lines open. Live phone lines open, because I want you guys to challenge me, because I know it's coming. And I'm going to learn you guys a lot of things. If you have never taken notes on my show before, the night that I discuss the comparison between slavery in the US and the Holocaust. Ooh, baby. Because I want to tell you guys right now, I'm going to have that conversation. Talk radio was brought about to have conversations that other people are either not having or afraid to have. And yes, this is going to be a very deep conversation. I don't want to have it by myself. I need some scholars sitting with me. I'd like to have some, if I can find some Holocaust survivors that want to speak with me. Because again, we're not vilifying them. We're just having a conversation about these two pivotal parts of history. Very, very pivotal. And a lot of times these conversations come up in concert of each other. Get over one thing, get over one thing, get over one thing. So I want to have this conversation on the show, right? But yes, this reparations bill falls short. I was going to tell you guys, get your bags packed. All black people, we're about to move our asses to Evanston, Illinois, right? We're going to start checking housing prices and rental prices right now. But no, no, that falls quite short of what I thought that was going to be. So again, live, unscripted, and uncensored radio here on the Worldwide Wednesdays on Talk Radio. We've got one more new to play, and then I'm going to just let the music run on a nice smooth down kind of situation for you guys with all the slow jams and the wind downs from your long day and your long drives today. So the next new for the evening is called Jetpack by Fabo on the Worldwide Wednesdays musical mix at 6 on Talk Radio.
Say Rosart.
I got the bank head bounce. I got the iRobot. I got the CC key.
That key.
I'm with a 3D thought. I'm on that good tomorrow.
Yeah.
I'm on that slim Calhoun. I got the cool breeze on me right now. Call me Daniel Boone.
Watch the jetpack.
Jetpack. I got the suited up jetpack. I got the booted up jetpack. She wanna tooted up jetpack. 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 I got the suited up jetpack. I got the booted up jetpack. She wanna tooted up jetpack. Jetpack.
I'm on 285. I'm on 85. I'm on 75. That's how I feel inside.
Tape on the clip. Bloody on both sides. Already got 100 round in it. Look, look, bitch, I'm winning. Even got the front window tinted. You got the shotgun, bitch. I got the see-through pack. Call me Peepo Shawty, bitch. I got to see through that. Ooh, call me Mr. Ouija, bitch. I got to teach you that. Put the sprinklers on me, bitch.
TAWK Radio.
Hold up, this, that. Hey, hey, hey. Ain't no conversation, bitch, when the 10's in play. These ain't the 7.5, this that instant replay. This that Friday after next, bitch. Ain't no way, this day, day. I got the bank head bounce. I got the iRobot. I got the CC key.
That key.
I'm with a 3D thot. I'm on that good tomorrow.
Yeah.
I'm on that slim Calhoun. I got the cool breeze on me right now. Call me Daniel Boone.
Watch the jetpack.
Jetpack. I got the suited up jetpack. I got the booted up jetpack. She wanna tooted up jetpack. Jetpack. Jetpack.
Jetpack.
I got the suited up jetpack.
Jetpack.
I got the booted up jetpack.
Jetpack.
She wanna tooted up jetpack. Jetpack. You like to look out the window.
Yeah.
I like to look out the front door.
I
got the mood on space age. You gotta crank it up pronto. I got the 18 rounds. I'ma go all four downs. Bitch, I'm a 2C clown. You gotta juice me down. Ooh, ooh, pay man. Bitch, taught me.
TAWK Radio Worldwide Wednesday.
You ain't got no panties. You gotta spin around this. You gotta walk it out. You gotta dance a little bit, bitch. You gotta talk it out. Ooh, ooh, you got to make that face. Ooh, you got to make that face.
Face.
You got to bite on lips. You got to run that race.
Ooh.
Best friend got your keys.
Yeah.
You got to make that case.
That case.
Now your eyesight leads.
Ow.
You got the combat rate.
Right.
I got the bank head bounce.
Ow.
I got the iRobot. I got the CC key.
That key.
I'm with a 3D thot. I'm on that good tomorrow.
Yeah.
I'm on that slim Calhoun.
Yeah.
I got the cool breeze on me right now. Call me Daniel Boone.
Hold up.
Jetpack. Jetpack. I got the suited up jetpack. I got the booted up jetpack. She wanna tooted up jetpack. Jetpack. Jetpack.
Jetpack.
I got the suited up jetpack.
Jetpack.
I got the booted up jetpack.
Jetpack.
She wanna tooted up jetpack.
Now I'm just that
super excited. You must be a playboy hottie. You on your acid trip. You on that molly. Stop, drop, and roll. Middle of the road. Middle of the stage. Middle of the floor. Ooh, jetpack.
TAWK Radio with your hostess Cypher Kai on the ones and twos tonight on www.tawkradio.com/shows. I was supposed to do some weird news for you tonight, wasn't I? Let me see if I can find it. There was an article. I wanted to do Weird News Wednesday, right? So something, a headline from an article caught my attention. I didn't read it, but I'm going to see if I can find it now and read it now, because why not? Let's try this and see what you guys think of it. Please also come back for the Friday show. The Freaky Friday show this week is going to be really turned up. We're doing the ABC's the ABC's of Sex series continuation, the letter K. I've got no idea what terms we're going to find out, but I do have like three or four different sex articles you guys sent me in and what my feedback on. I've not read them. I've only seen the headlines, and they seem that they're going to be very interesting things to talk about. Yeah. And we just talk like we're grown on Fridays. Fridays is the let your hair down, you know, get with your boo, learn some things, some tactics, some techniques, some whatevers, right? Some whatevers here on the Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio with your host, Cypher Kai. Something caught my attention. I'm sorry, you guys. So I keep forgetting also to tell you guys, we've got a 24/7 hotline number set up specifically for the talkers, 24/7, you can call and vent, leave your messages, reach out for assistance, all that kind of stuff. 347-450-3958, 347-450-3958. For the international talkers, you can reach us on facebook.com/TAWKRADIO. All right, so here's the weird news for this Wednesday. This is from thesun.com. It says, get a wriggle on. Huge 59-foot tapeworm slithers out of Thai man's rectum after he complained to doctors he was farting too much. Yes, I said that. Mm-hmm. Written by Tariq Tahir, March 24, 2020. What's the day? All right. Doctors were shocked when a 59-foot long tapeworm slithered out of a man's bottom after he had complained of farting too much. The 67-year-old patient visited the hospital complaining of tummy pains and flatulence in Nong Khai province, Thailand, earlier this month. He was unaware of any problems and a stool sample was sent to medics at the Parasitic Disease Research Center in neighboring, I can't pronounce the name, in a neighboring province, but tests showed it contained 28 eggs and man was given deworming medicine, niclosamide, before the giant parasite oozed out of his bottom the next day on March 28th. Hoy. Footage shows astonished medics unfurling the mammoth 59-foot parasite and laying it on a mat. Doctors believe the parasite came from infected and uncooked beef that contained eggs. Ew. Okay, right now. All right, so let's stop there. So what? Okay, here's the thing. And this is why you guys need to be very mindful of what you're eating, right? And cook it all the way through. Now, when I first saw this thing, I said, okay, maybe it's a typo because 59 feet is really long, like really long. So I said, maybe it's 59 inches. Even that's really tall too. But 59 feet, I'm looking at the picture here. It's like they took it out and it's like curling and furling and curling and furling. So they said he had some beef that seems like it was infected, had some kind of maggots in it with their own things. You eat it, you don't cook it properly, and you get these things in your system. Oh my God. So that is something. It is more inspiring now for me to become vegan. I've been thinking about it, right? Wanting to make some lifestyle changes. Just wanted to do better, be around for you guys for a long time. You know, I'd like to get to meet my grandkids that I don't have yet, you know, so it's just all these little things. And so, yeah, this definitely wakes me up a little to being much more mindful about what I'm eating and stuff. Tapeworms. Anyway, that was the weird news. So let's continue on with the musical portion of the show. So just like I said, some wind down music, some slow jams, a little neo soul type stuff we're going to play here to finish off the show with. And so the next one is going to be BMO by Ari Lennox here on the Worldwide Wednesdays musical mix at 6 on Talk Radio. WK Radio. WK Radio.
garbanzo beans and see if they cooked yet.
TAWK Radio with your hostess Cypher Kai on this Worldwide Wednesday's musical mix at 6 on Talk Radio. Thank you guys so much for being here. This one is going to be Miss Erica Badu, On and On, here on the Worldwide Wednesdays on www.tawkradio.com/shows. As you can notice, I'm talking through it. This is a long version. You know, live, unscripted, uncensored radio. So I'll just keep you guys company until the song actually starts. You know, it's kind of vibing. I have no idea what this sounds like, but you know, it's all good. Live radio, you guys. Live radio. One of my favorite neo-soul songs, by the way. Got to have a conversation with her one day on Talk Radio. She is absolutely amazing. AWK Radio Worldwide Wednesdays. WK Radio. AWK Radio's Worldwide Wednesday musical mix at 6 on Talk Radio with your hostess Cypher Kai, Erica Badu, Bag Lady. AWK Radio. WK Radio with Cypher Kai. WK Radio. Bag Lady here on the Worldwide Wednesdays Musical Mixer 6 on Talk Radio. This one is Backbone by Bria Janet, Worldwide Wednesdays.
Point out your head if you agree. Don't let something
KWK Radio. AWK Radio, Cloud 9, Candy Willett on the Worldwide Wednesdays.
I wish my butt was bigger, I wish my head was smaller, I wish I had more self-control, I wish I didn't wonder, I wish I had more money, I wish I knew exactly where I wanted to go, I thought it'd be so easy. I wish the sky was brighter, I wish the day was longer, I wish I felt all the love of a higher power. I wish I never faded, I wonder if I'll make it. I wish I never knew the pain of being brokenhearted, yeah. But there's something about the way you love. There's no doubt in your eyes. Got me on cloud nine. Every time you hold me close, your kiss drives me wild.
AWK Radio. WK Radio. Worldwide Wednesdays Around by Sun Queen Kelsey is the exolude of the evening on Talk Radio.
Practicing my smile, I wanna be perfect. When I get to see you, when I get to be closer to you, I'm a brave girl, but you make me nervous. I know I'm deserving. I hope you like surprises. What I'm about to tell ya, and what I'm about to show ya, and what I'ma say, and what I'ma do. What I'm about to tell ya, and what I'm about to show ya, and what I'ma say to make you a believer. You might think you've been around. But baby, it's my turn. Baby, it's my turn. And you
TAWK Radio.
You say you're getting bored. But baby, it's my turn. Baby, it's my turn to make your world go around and around and around, round, round, round. To trying to get you for a while. You know the saying, good things come to those who wait. Shoot your shot, don't hesitate. I'm trying to give you more than butterflies. I'm more than meets the eye, more than you can dream of. And you don't have to turn out the lights. I told you I'm gonna make you a
WK Radio. WK Radio's Worldwide Wednesdays, March 24, 2021, with your host, Cypher Kai. This has been another installment of the Worldwide Wednesdays on www.tawkradio.com/shows. Please come back and spend some time with me for the continuation of the ABCs of Sex series, The Letter K, that will be coming up on Friday, March 26, 2021, starting at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. If you came into this episode late, please feel free to reload the page, the website page, when I get off the air, immediately after I get off the air, www.tawkradio.com/shows. The archive is there, along with another 120 episodes, I believe. They will not always be available, you guys. The best gift that you can give yourself if you're a talker is to buy yourself a USB and download all of the archive episodes. There's lots of Easter eggs and gems in there for you guys to win lots of money in the coming months. They will not always be available, so please do yourself a favor, spend $15 and download those episodes if you're truly a talker and want to partake in all of the gift giving and giveaways and cash that we'll be doling out in the coming months. All right, you guys. So thank you so much for hanging out with me, spending some time with me, you guys. Share the link around, go back into the archives. I do truly appreciate you guys and your support, and I will be back by God's grace on Friday at 8 p.m. for the Freaky Fridays on Talk Radio. Good night, my lovelies.